On Nationwide this evening, the story of how a stained glass window has brought a family back to Tralee.
Our first story this evening takes us to Kerry, where a stained glass window has brought one of Tralee's most famous historical families back to the town that they were associated with for over 300 years.
A century after the last of the Anglo-Irish Denny family left Kerry, they've been welcomed back with open arms. In St John's Church in Tralee in October, there was a ceremony to mark a five-year journey that the community has taken with Tom Denny, a grandson of the last of the Dennys to walk the streets of Tralee.
I welcome you all to St John's on this very historical and special evening.
At one time, the Dennys owned most of Tralee and much of the surrounding countryside.
They were big-scale landowners. They arrived in the 16th century and stayed till the beginning of the 20th. And as well as most of the town, they also owned something like 25,000 acres surrounding it.
Unlike many of the Anglo-Irish landed gentry, the Dennys weren't driven from Ireland by the IRA in the 1920s. They weren't burned out or cut down to size by the Wyndham Land Acts, which forced landlords to sell to their tenants. The demise in the Dennys' fortunes was altogether more ordinary.
The reason they lost their estate in Kerry was through reckless gambling rather than through anything that happened in the wider in wider Irish history. Sadly, there was a character called Arthur Denny, who was his uncle, Sir Edward Denny's heir. Arthur built up gambling debts against his uncle's life. The uncle was a member of the Plymouth Brethren and had scruples about paying off gambling debts. He felt it was immoral. So he wouldn't help his nephew. And so the debts just built up and up and up. Interest built up until, by the time Sir Edward finally died, his nephew stepped into the Denny baronetcy, but his debts gobbled up the whole thing. So it was more like a sort of 18th century loss than a 20th century loss, you know, a gambling away of the estate kind of loss.
Tom Denny is a stained glass artist based in Dorset in England. He was aware of the family's Irish heritage and was invited to the launch of two books on the people who once lived in the big houses of Ireland.
I personally had always felt that there was more than we knew to be discovered about the people of the big houses, their personal lives and their histories, but they're so much part of our national history, and the houses have been well documented, the interiors and the exteriors and the fabrics of the houses, but not so well documented has been the personal stories.
In addition to the book launch, we found that we were to be welcomed back into the town of Tralee as the current Denny family, and there was a sort of formal ceremony of welcoming the Dennys back, and it was wonderful. It was a feeling that now our particular kind of Irishness can also be celebrated and recognised. It was a feeling that it was, in its own tiny way, part of what's happened under the wing of the Good Friday Agreement.
By coincidence, Tom lives only a few minutes from Stirminster Newton, where the famed Irish stained glass artist Harry Clark left his mark in a stunning window in the village's Anglican church nearly a century ago.
It would be lovely to make a work in the land of Harry Clark himself, that great Irish stained glass artist from the early 20th century. The main things about that window are the colour of the glass itself.
A public meeting in Tralee followed, where Tom outlined how he works and showed some of his previous windows, as the community began to look at commissioning a stained glass artist to construct a new window for St John's.
Someone in the town council of Tralee suggested that because I was a stained glass artist and because I was a member of the Denny family, those things could have some significance and meaning if I was to make a window for the Catholic Church, the church that wasn't the church where my family worshipped, but that idea, which would embody ideas of reconciliation and reconnection.
One of the exciting discoveries in researching your family is your descent from the Gaelic Septs as well as the settler, the McGillicuddies of the Reeks.
Yes.
And then, of course, the Old English, the Knights of Kerry Fitzgerald. So you begin with a head start, I suppose.
So Tom got the commission to design and fit a new stained glass window for St. John's Church on the theme of reconciliation.
This is where we're hoping to place this new window. It's on the western side of St. John's Church here in Tralee. This style of communication and reflection has been going on for centuries, and it invites us back into something that has always been there. It really touches our soul or our hearts or some other part of us that we don't engage with most of the time.
For over a year, Tom worked away in his studio in his back garden in Dorset.
In my life, I find that my studio is a house of prayer, in a sense, and that the process of working is like a process of prayer. And so in many ways, the most intense part of my spiritual life is grappling with my windows.
This central light is about the story of the prodigal son.
So after 3 years, Tom's stained glass window is now ready for fitting. But there's a big storm approaching.
It's 4 minutes to eight. Let's get that very important weather forecast now. Let's cross to Met Aaron, join Vincent O'Shea. Vincent, where is ex-Hurricane Ophelia at the moment?
Well, it's just making landfall on the Kerry coast.
And we'll be back later in the programme to show you Tom's vision for a new reconciliation window at St. John's.
You're welcome back to Nationwide. Well, we have been following the story of a community in Tralee who came up with the idea of a stained glass window to mark the town's 800th anniversary. And the project also welcomed back a family who had been associated with the town for 300 of those years.
Tom Denny's family connection to Kerry goes back to the 16th century. The Dennys owned 25,000 acres around Tralee, a castle and most of the town. But it was all lost to gambling debts, and finally Tom's grandfather, a rector, left Ireland in 1908 due to a quirk of faith, so to speak.
He was a Church of Ireland clergyman, and he was unhappy about the way the Church of Ireland was moving, and that was the specific thing that made him want to go to England. He felt the Church of Ireland at that time was moving too close to Presbyterianism and was becoming too low church for his liking. He said, it's not the sort of churchmanship I like. I like the, you know, the more ritual and so on. So he took the decision to go to England.
And last autumn, after over 100 years of absence, the Dennys arrived back in Tralee, led by the Dorset-based stained glass artist Tom Denny. His task was to install a new stained glass window in St. John's Church in Tralee to mark the town's 800th anniversary.
Is that in a reasonable place, that tie?
Yeah, it's fine.
The community definitely became involved and supported it, and that was important for us from the start, you know, rather than going off and getting corporate sponsorship and stuff like that. It's very important to have the community involved, that everybody can say, well, you know, I contributed in some small way to this, something that's going to be there for hundreds of years. We had a hurricane, so that was a hairy moment, but everything went very well.
In the design, they're just suggested as little areas of colour, a little bit cloud-like, you know, sort of linking the two main stories either side. But I decided they could become little heavenly cloudscapes. And each of them contains a small company of heaven from Tralee at different dates. There's Margaret, Barry, Timothy Ridey, Mary O'Leary.
one or two from the St John's F Street congregation, like Babs Godfrey.
Nicholas Matchett, who was a well-known parish priest of this church.
It's quite nice that these people, you know, who all walked past one another in the streets of Tralee 270 years ago, and now clustered together in a little window.
Well, this is one piece of glass that Tom has used. And generally, a piece of glass is just one colour, but he's done such a lot of work on it. He's acid etched the colours away. And he's used two pieces of glass. He's used pink, gold pink, which is made of gold, and green. And he's also used silver stain, which gives this lovely rich orangey yellow.
Last Friday we completed the last panel there, and of course there was storm forecast that day as well, and when we moved up and put the head on John the Baptist, the sun shone, so it was great. I think he certainly intervened for the afternoon, and it was lovely we got it finished on the Friday.
The window is called the Window of Reconciliation, and the theme is reconciliation, and there are different ways one can think about that. Of course, the window is built up of stories from the Bible, which come at the idea of reconciliation from different angles. So it's partly simply forgiveness, but partly healing and new life and the overcoming of enmity and the expression of love.
In the window, Tom has captured the Kerry fauna and flora, the pebbles on the beach, the rich bird life, a local beetle, and even the rare Kerry slug.
I think in particular, I really love that centre panel, because I suppose everybody can associate in families and communities and everything with the Prodigal Son. And I think in particular, and since I first saw it in Tom's studio, the faces on the children, where one of them is very, very cross, the other one is very joyful that his brother has come back. And then if you look at the little girl here, I think she really doesn't know what to do. She doesn't know what she's going to be. She's probably very glad that he's back, but she sees a lot of people are angry and she doesn't really know what to do.
Along with the community in Tralee, members of the Denny family contributed to the cost of the window, and they came to the ceremony to reconnect with part of their family history.
For members of the Denny family, it is revelatory to think that our ancestors, for hundreds of years, were deeply familiar with the stone flags of the Tralee streets. And now, a new participation is offered in the form of this window, in what is for me the most wonderful and important project of my career. A stained glass window with lofty ambitions. Can a work of art do something significant? Can it really be part of the process of reconciliation? It can at least be a field for contemplation.
People don't commission windows very often, and to have a window that's put this church, it's just a really precious item. And then how that changes people and how it brings people together is remarkable, actually. I'm just astonished by the whole thing. It's lovely to be here.
I think it was just such a positive and uplifting experience. It became an opportunity for neighbours to meet neighbours. It became an opportunity for us to learn about other communities and to integrate and to grow and to develop as communities. And it became, I would certainly say, for us in St John's and for the town of Tralee, probably one of the most positive engagements that we've had in a very long time. We're very proud of it.
A wonderful new piece of art at St John's Church in Tralee.
Well, we've come to the end of this evening's programme. I hope you enjoyed seeing a masterpiece being restored and a town welcoming back one of its own.
Comorthus Mori Goni, Egan Fla Comorthus Namani Kayla. Bond Sulf Osan Spree Egan Kuplanomade, Lejon Magazine.